four of us that founded the company are photographers at heart. And when we got together in 2010, the first thing we did was actually launch a photography competition. It was the world's first mobile photography exhibition, and we realized that we tapped into something that is, you know, way bigger than we had thought. And that it became clear that there was potential there to build a company. EyeEm is a community at heart. It's a community for photographers. It's a way for you to take photos, process them, share them, and get a lot of feedback. You can learn, you become a better photographer. It also has quite a wide array of discovery functionality that lets you sort of discover places and people based on the kind of photos that you take and the kind of interests that you have. It's about the beauty of photography. It's about photography in its purest form.
Design is a big, big part of what we do. And the photos are not created by us. So what we try to build and design is a canvas for any photo to look at it best. We made several changes to make our app simpler, to streamline the experience, and that definitely plays into our engagement metrics. The most visible one is probably the menu. We removed several items from the navigation to make it clearer what EyeEm is about. Now you have access to the three main parts of the app, which are a discover feed to discover new content and content that was published around you, your friends feed, which is where you find all the photos of your friends and the photographers you follow, and missions are photo competitions. People post photos around a certain topic and then win prizes and get published. They access friends and discover somewhere between 50 and 80% more than before, and missions saw a more than 100% increase in access. We also saw an increase in people participating in missions because of the way we restructured the data. One of the other additions we made to the Android app to make photographers' life easier was to improve the camera button and the interactions with it. So you tap on the camera button, it pulls your most recent images, no matter where they come from, and you also have the option to use your camera or access to the full gallery. By keeping a single action there, we've seen a 73% increase in people accessing our camera. We've also seen increases across the board of people editing photos with EyeEm and uploading photos as well. Designing for different screen sizes and different resolutions is not as hard as people usually say. The Android guidelines help you navigate through the different formats, be it phones or tablets, portrait or landscape, and definitely act as a guide and help you adapt your design and the feature sets you have to different screen sizes. We think it's important to follow Android design guidelines because that's what people expect when they're on the Android platform. It's important to keep those patterns in mind and also to leverage them because that's the easiest way for people to know how your app is used.
What started as a facelift became basically us stripping down the app. And what that led to is a much more photocentric experience, a much more streamlined experience, a much faster experience. We saw growth, engagement, and retention, and usage across the board on every single metric that we have.